The other big development over the weekend is, of course, the merger of IDFC as well as Capital First. In fact, over the last couple of trading sessions, you've seen IDFC being a star performer. The stock price, if you look at the last week or so, up by nearly 20%. Here's the management on the road ahead.
Dr. Lall, Mr. Vaidyanathan, thank you so much for taking time out and speaking with us. Congratulations. You announced the merger on Saturday. It's a win-win for both IDFC and Capital First. Dr. Lall, do take us through the contours of the deal. When did you change your heart, really? In October, the deal with Shriram Group was called off. And when did you first go to Capital First for this merger proposal? And why is it a good match?
So, not too long after the exclusivity period was over, so around mid-November, it's taken us 2 months pretty much to the date. What makes the deal work? Well, it works at very many levels. I mean, first is just in terms of trust and chemistry between the principals. Second is it's a very good strategic fit for us. Our stated strategy is aggressive retailization. We tried to do that with Shriram. That was the idea of connecting with SCUF. This is much cleaner. Gives us high-yielding retail assets growing very rapidly. Gives us expanded branch network. Most importantly, it brings us, you know, 3 million additional customers, so that the joint franchise has over 5 million customers. And even more importantly, it brings us Mr. Vaidyanathan. So we've been looking for a retail head for quite a while. He brings all the requisite experience that IDFC Bank or the combined entity will need for its future. So it just works at so many levels. I think that the case for IDFC Bank shareholders is pretty strong.
I'd actually think that IDFC Bank, after getting a license in the last 2 years ago, getting a license in India by itself is a long task. Putting up the technology, putting up the architecture, putting up the networks, putting up 100 branches. I think they've really done a lot of work, and have great admiration for Rajiv for giving the leadership for making all of this happen. From our point of view, at some point of time, we, whether now or within 3 years or 4 years, we would have looked at converting to a bank, because we believe that a bank becomes a much more sustainable journey that can last.
Mr. Vaidyanathan, a couple of months back, I met you at a book launch, and you mentioned that you want to run a bank. And if this merger had not happened, any which way, 2 to 3 years, you would be scouting for a license, a universal banking license. Now that you have the opportunity with IDFC Bank to take the tie-up, what really was it that you found very attractive about IDFC Bank that made you believe that this could be a good proposition to grow your plans in this area?
Yes, indeed, at Tamil's function, as well as maybe 3 or 4 functions over the last 3 years, I have always said that, you know, people have often said that, look, NBFC is having a dream run, but we cannot always live in a dream run. We've got to figure out a permanent dream run. A banking platform makes it almost a permanent print run, because there is a freeway for growth forever and ever, because your liability base becomes low cost, but more than low cost, becomes stable. That's what we were after. So, of course, we could have waited 3 or 4 years, there was no hurry. But then, you know, sometimes your providence comes, you get a good opportunity, and these kind of opportunities like Rajiv Lall, they don't come very often.
What will the merged entity look like? What will the rebranding be? And what will the capital structure look like once the merger is completed in 6 to 9 months?
As far as the branding is concerned, we have both talked about it, and we spent time talking about it even before we announced this merger. We said that, look, both brands are very important. Capital First is a consumer brand known to, say, 5 million customers and their families and their networks. The IDFC Bank is an extremely important brand, a very solid brand, and people think very high of the brand. So we said among ourselves that as the time progresses, we will find a way of putting both brands together in the combined bank and call it a bank. So the exact word is capital, you know, capital IDFC Bank or IDFC First Bank. We have some options, but we're working on it.
The IDFC Bank will, shareholders will end up with about 72% of the combined entity. What it means is that our principal shareholder, largest shareholder, IDFC Limited, their ownership will come down from 54 to a little lower than 40%. You will recall that IDFC by regulation had to bring down its ownership share in the bank to 40% by October of this year, And therefore, another very elegant feature of this combination is that it allows IDFC shareholders to do just that without disturbing the market too much or creating an overhang on the IDFC Bank stock. Otherwise, all the other regulatory conditions will be pretty much met. I think Global Pinkers will end up with a little a shade over 10%, and they will seek RBI permission to keep their stake between 5% and 10%. So, the larger shareholder on their side, IDFC shareholders on our side, that's the broad composition of the merged entity.
Dr. Lall, one key reason driving your decision for a merger of this kind is the prospect of growing your retail book. As for the merger with Capital First, apart from really growing your presence in the retail segment, what other cost savings and synergies are you expecting? Also, what will the combined balance sheet look like and what will be the new operating metrics that you are hopeful for?
So I'll just talk about the combined balance sheet and margins and all for the future. I think Vaidyanathan is the right person to share his views on that. Just arithmetically, if you combine the two, we get to advances of close to 88,000 crores. Our stated objective was to take the share of retail assets to over 50% within three years. And I think we would have achieved that with this merger. Also on the balance sheet side, there are the SLR CRR requirements. This will require about 6,000 crores of additional SLR. We have 2,000 crores of excess SLR sitting on our books already. So we will raise another 4,000 crores in treasury to meet the regulatory requirements.
By what extent do you think cost of funds will improve going forward?
As far as the margins are concerned, Capital First right now has margins in terms of excess of 8%, and I think that's pretty healthy, and that will carry into the new institution. Mm-hmm. And more than having a 23,000 crore book is the ability to create a 23,000 crore book, because that's more important. On a month-on-month basis, we're adding on a large customer franchise, and we also have our distribution network across the country, which is able to generate high quality, low NPA, high quality retail loans, which will carry. Now, as far as IDFC is concerned, of course, largely an infrastructure player, and I think they also have their initial stages of retail business. Now, the story is not about what the NIMs will look like tomorrow morning. The story is about the bigger picture. Okay, here's a retail institution, here's an infrastructure lending institution, put the two pieces together, you get the strength of an infrastructure financing, you get the strength of a retail financing, and mind you, the value that a infrastructure financing business brings to the book is also very, very high, because it gives you the earnings to be able to invest in retail and grow the combined balance sheet. So I greatly appreciate what the IDFC Bank has already built, and I think with retail on top of it, it will become a very powerful combination.
You do mention that there will be an improvement in cost of funds and borrowing costs will be lower. Do you think this will be offset by the expected rise in provisioning costs going forward?
So now, as far as cost of funds is concerned, now Capital First incremental borrowing is anywhere about 8.2%. In today's market, it was about 8% 3 months ago when the yields had not gone up. And of course, CP prices are even lesser, like the mid 6.5% or something like that. Now, obviously, a bank platform allows you to raise money at a lower cost than that. And therefore, there's a significant benefit to be garnered or got by this transition for Capital First. And as far as IDFC is concerned, if their lending yields, let me assume for a minute, is maybe 11% or in that zone, the incremental lending for Capital First is 18%. So there's a big play that they're adding to that space. So blend, I think, without getting into the specific metric of what the number to the last decimal point would look like, I think when you put the pieces together, there is benefit to be gained on the top line, there are benefits to be gained on the cost of funds because of the mix, and therefore, by definition, therefore, in theory, the margins, the profitability should look better.
Taking that point forward, you spoke about a strong balance sheet. What will the combined entity's capital adequacy ratio be?
It's pretty simple. They are at upwards of about 18%,
right,
and we are upwards of 18%. Okay. So capital adequacy, frankly, for both institutions, very strong. We don't need capital. I'd like to just keep this on record. We don't need capital when we start out this institution together. So we will play it as it comes from there on.
The reason I ask that question is to get a sense on what will be the capital consumption on a quarterly basis going forward. Do you think you will require more capital in, say, about 1 year or so?
At our growth requirements, doesn't look like for the next 2 or 3 years we don't need capital, and we will take it from there.
When you talk about expansion plans, I have to ask you this question. Would you consider inorganic opportunities as well in the retail and MFI portfolio?
Okay, no problem. You have every right to ask the question. But right now, our entire focus and energies are in consummating this transaction. This transaction by itself is going to take 6 to 9 months of hard work. We've got to put the pieces together and make it run. It's not difficult, but it will happen. And we should be very focused on building this institution.
Essentially, Mr. Vaidyanathan, what is your long-term plan? What is your vision for the next 5 years? What are some of the milestones or goals that you are targeting to achieve in the coming years?
The big picture is for to have a banking platform which can grow, which is in some niche areas which where value can be created, where technology plays a very significant role, and create an institution which is gives us a lot of peace of mind in terms of what the quality of the book is looking like. I'm very focused on asset quality and growth and profitability. So I think with those metrics in mind, I think we've got to build it. There is, we believe that the CASA ratio of the bank should continuously improve. We believe that the asset quality should continuously improve. And I think these are the big focus we're looking at. We have not pegged a number, nor would we like to share and put a number on the ground today. But I think one thing is certain, that directionally, I have zero doubt in my mind that we are on to a really, really big thing, because now this is a perennial institution and it is not going to be dependent on wholesale funding.
Since you say you are on expansion mode, what will the workforce look like in the coming years? Essentially, I'm trying to understand, would you be looking to hire more in the coming years once the merged entity gets regulatory approvals in about 6 to 9 months?
I would say, the way I think about it, I use the word peace of mind bank. A peace of mind bank comes when retail substantial portion, because retail is not just asset quality. Retail gives a lot of micro relationships where you can target the an employees, or we can partner in a small individual's life over the lifespan of the employee. So big story is retail, and therefore you could just imagine or expect from us that more than 50%, maybe 60 or 65% of this institution will be retail as the years roll by.
Dr. Lall, you are a veteran in this space. You have years of experience behind you. Now, as you get ready to pass on the baton to Mr. Vaidyanathan, what are your words of advice given the current challenges in the banking sector?
I'm making a very big bet that Vaidyanathan is going to build a bank like no other. Two aspects of this I want to emphasize. One is that where there is complete meeting of minds and vision is institution building. You know, he keeps using the word a perennial organization. My dream is really to leave behind an institution. So over the next 10, 15, 20 years, that's what I hope and expect will be built. That's
That was the big management of IDFC, as well as V. Vaidyanathan of Capital First. V. Vaidyanathan, as always, bullish about the retail space and saying that why he needs a bank for a sustainable business, and that's essentially the key takeaways. NBFC has been on a dream run, but to have a sustainable dream run, IDFC or a bank, or you know, to get the way forward is to get a bank. They have always mentioned about the banking space, but now this merger has come through. An interesting interview, and throughout the day we'll be getting you this exclusive interaction that we had with the top management at IDFC as well as Capital First. Taking a break, coming back in 2 minutes.